In the days when you had to fight to put food in your belly, you had to be a bit special to make it to the top of the pile. A bare-knuckle warrior with hands of steel, there was only one winner, and that was Bill. William O'Driscoll, born in Mallow, County Cork, Ireland in 1888. The story really begins in 1907 when he was 18. Bill was helping some friends in the struggle against the British by smuggling arms across the border. Bill and his friends were eventually caught and sent to the notorious prison on Spike Island, which was run by the British. There was no love lost between the guards and the prisoners, and Bill knew his life was in danger if he stayed in the prison. So he hatched a plan. After dark, knowing that there was 9 hours until the guards checked the prisoners, he swam the 50 minutes across the water to the mainland in the safety of the shore the other side. The authorities were furious about his escape. He was hunted high and low by the Black and Tans, an undisciplined security force of the British Army. Bill joined the circus, having beaten their house fighter. He became the new circus champion and fought one and all. Any man that came, Bill fought and beat. Fighting in the boxing booth, his reputation grew day by day. But it was this that caused his downfall. The Black and Tans, getting wind of where he was working, set a trap to catch him. Bill heard of the trap and left the circus, once again going on the run. Bill was back on the run with his wife Nora, a Romany gypsy, in their barrel-top caravan, until one day his luck ran out and he was captured by the Black and Tans and put in prison with the intention of putting him against the wall and shooting him. Bill made his escape with the Black and Tans in hot pursuit, and once again it was the water that saved him as he swam across the River Lee to safety. The Black and Tans thought he had surely drowned, but Bill was made of sterner stuff and he made it to the other side. Hiding in the woods, he managed to evade the Black and Tans for many years. Or travelling the country in their barrel-top caravan, making money where and when they could. Life then took a turn, with his beloved Nora dying at the age of 40. Life was hard then, especially with avoiding the Black and Tans. Nora must have loved him very much, as he did her. In the early 1920s, a challenge was put out to Bill by King Maud. Although Bill never challenged people himself, he was never one to turn down a fight, and travelled the long journey to Dublin, where they fought for 2 hours, it is said, in a car park. Bill eventually beat King Maud, and he was now the new king. But this meant, over the years, he received many more challenges, many of these to be fought on the cobbled streets or at the horse fairs. Bill fought characters with such names as Jack the Terror. He eventually retired, undefeated, having won the approval of his peers and the community. There was even a film made about him called Strength and Honour. Some of his sons carried on his legacy and they too were winners. Bill died at the grand old age of 82. This is the story of Bill O'Driscoll. A winner in every respect. This is only part of the story of a fascinating man. To read the whole story, get the book When Men Were Men.